5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hello, 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 and welcome back to Space Engineers on the Xbox, on the Series X. And today, we're going to look at my Sun Scout. You remember it? I used this as my demonstration vehicle build for the atmospheric exploration vehicle to help you find resources and scoot along a planet. But what happens if you are on a planet where you have access to lots of ice, say like Triton, or even if you land near an ice lake over there on the Earth? Like, well, your options are to stick with atmospheric engines, or if you can find cobalt and basically get a good source, you could have a combination atmospheric and hydrogen ship, or you could just go for hydrogen. If you've got lots of ice, hydrogen is a good fuel source, and because of the rebalance, it doesn't get chewed so quickly. But here is my little thing. Let's just shut this down completely. This is ripe for converting into a hydrogen-powered ship. And I wanted to do a little bit of a conversion without using symmetry mode. We're going to just do this on the fly here. And I'm going to talk about hydrogen as I do it. Don't need the large thruster. I don't need that block. This isn't going to be a space vehicle, so I mean, it potentially could break atmo using hydrogen engines. But honestly, it wouldn't take too much to remove all that across the top there and just link in the cockpit to our generators. So what we have so far is a shell of a ship. And now we can look at how we would convert this ship into using hydrogen. And what I like to do with hydrogen is I like at least 2 generators in my system. And when you're doing small grid, you can use the small grid hydrogen tanks as well to cut down on ship size. Remember, this isn't meant to be a ship that will go for ages and ages and ages and ages. This is a hydrogen scout, in essence. So what we want is we want to look at our O2 generation first. So our O2 H2 generation, we're going to drop one in there, and then we're going to need some way to store our hydro. Say hello to my little friend. Pop. And if you notice, the ports on that have lined up with the ports on this. And now what we want is I like to put at least 2 generators, and I need a link to be able to link into the hydrogen system on this ship in general. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to find another generator. I'm going to slap it there. And then I'm going to grab some small conveyors, just the blocks for now, because I need a way out into my hydrogen system, like so. And I'm gonna need another rank of those there as well, just in case I want to do any further messing about with this system. Going to need some power as well, but don't worry about that for now. What we're gonna do here is we're gonna use some small grid batteries for the time being. Just a few batteries there. And always fun trying to get these in the right place. And finally, may as well make things nice and neat. Those will be our backup batteries, though, more than anything. So now, let's look at the hydrogen system itself. We have two generators, three tanks to store fuel, and now we need to make it so that we can lift the ship. Now, you can use the calculator, which I showed you in the iron thruster video, but in this case we're going to keep it nice and simple. We're going to use some hydrogen thrusters, the regular ones, just in case you don't have the heavy industry DLC. Put two there. And we're going to put two here. So always equalize your thrust front and back. Makes it easier when you're starting and stopping. And then we're going to think, where are we going to provide lift from? Well, don't put it close to your landing gear because it will damage that landing gear. So if we snap our thing here by the battery, and we could actually pop one here as well, and then the same deal here and here. This will give us what we need to start playing around with the lift thrusters. So a lift thruster in there. Don't worry about this isn't creative, so we haven't got to worry about fuel being used. Lift thruster in there, so that's two so far. And you want one here. And yeah. Then we're almost sorted. What we'll need is we will need another small conveyor here and another small conveyor here. Then we'll switch to regular conveyors and we'll just link this lot up right to the front. And we'll link this lot up here, like so. Now, we've got two there, two there. Now we want to equalize the thrust. And we could leave those off because we're on an Earth-like. However, if you decide to make this an autopilot ship using the remote control block, it's going to need all thrusters in all directions so that the autopilot can work properly. And we're going to throw your hydrogen thrust there, like so. So now we have front, back, left, right, up, down. And that ship would be ready to fly-ish. Going to add the missing component just here. We'll drop a gyroscope in. Remember, no ship will fly without a gyroscope, or no ship will turn without a gyroscope. And now, we might want to boost our battery life a bit, just in case. I would suggest popping at least one battery, like so. And then you could, actually, looking at it, move that battery out of the way a second. We'll do that when this thing's in the air. So right now, because we modified the sand scout, we're going to need to drop our new thrusters on. So if you just tap your inventory button, which is on an Xbox controller, the two squares, the share button, or whatever you want to call it, and then just pop to your control panel, or you can hold both bumpers down and press that and go straight to your control panel. And you want to just use your search box and type HYD. And then look for all the thrusters, ignore any of the tanks. Press A on the first thruster, hold down the right bumper, move down to hydrogen thruster 10 or whatever it's called, hold down A, and then just keep tapping the D pad down while you've got both held down, and you'll select every single thruster. Ignore the tanks, don't do anything else, let go of both buttons and flick the left stick, not the D-pad, to the right until it reaches block group. Then just name it something. I'm just going to simply call it hide thrust. Save the group. And then you're ready to add that group to your cockpit. So hold down up on the D-pad in this case, tap the right bumper twice to groups, move the D-pad across till you reach hide thrust, select it with A, press A again on toggle block on off, and there we have access to our thrusters. As you can see, our thrusters, let's quickly save, we're on. And this thing is ready to fly. It has a battery life of about an hour. So what we want to do now is we want to extend that battery life. So let's look at popping a couple of bigger batteries on. Drop one here. Don't matter about covering up the conveyors now. And just for a bit of cosmetic fun, grab yourself a light armor block, change it to the slope on the D-pad, cycle your blocks, as you know, if you've been watching any of my tutorials, you'll know how to do that, and just pop some blocks in here. They don't do anything, just cosmetic, but they look as though they're holding the batteries in place, and you'll see that the ship will look different regardless. Better for it. Said before when I started this video, make sure that you've got a good source of ice. Even through the rebalance, the hydrogen thrusters will eat your fuel. It just won't go down as much. And that is your little inverted Hydro Scout from our friend over here, the Atmospheric Sand Scout. You've now got hydrogen version of the same thing. And what you want to do is you want to just take it a quick test fly. Save again. So we want to turn it on. So hold down the right bumper, tap down on the D-pad. And we've got 6 hour battery life on it. We're going to take it a quick spin, see how well it does. And bear in mind, it has an ore detector on it as well. Should be fairly maneuverable. And it should stop quite quickly. Always give yourself enough time. Break. Space engineers doesn't stop on a dime. Seems to be flying fairly well. Since I'm right close to an ice lake as well, if this was a survival save, we'd be laughing. Because we would have a massive, massive store of ice to which to keep a ship like this functioning. If you want to test it, see how well it does in survival when you built it, just you can convert your game that you're running here into a survival mode by changing the mode when you load the game. You can also create a copy save so that you can test it as well. That's what I tend to do. There it is in all its new glory and a basic hydrogen scout, little ore detector, and a very simple hydrogen thrust system. I mean, this is as basic as it gets. Not too many thrusters. It's not going to break the bank resources wise, and if you've got lots of resources anyway, it shouldn't be a problem. If you are concerned or you want to know exactly how many thrusters you need, you can look at the weight of the ship. Then if you visit my iron thruster tutorial, you can check that out and you'll see the link to the thrust calculator. Just pop the weight of the ship in and see how many thrusters it would take. It might only lift with one thruster on either side and so on, but I always prefer about four. I like to have options, and four is a good number to play around with. And the way you build this as well is, if you needed more thrusters, you can just snap one of these off with the grinder in survival, cut through a block, and then you will be able to add more thrusters as and when you need, and you're sorted. That's it. That is my quick introduction to a hydrogen build. Remember, always try and have at least a couple of generators in your system per hydrogen fuel tank. So play around with it, have fun, enjoy it. As I always say, have fun, enjoy the game. Warfare 2 is coming at some point this year. We will be looking forward to that. I certainly am. And there'll be more from me as time goes on. I will eventually go back to my new player guide survival save, and we will build our survival version of a scout. I'm not sure what I'm going to do with it yet, whether or not I want cargo on it or not, but that's for another time. Until the next time, have fun. Bye for now.